You know, I don't think you guys can see 100%.
I only recently fell in love with like sriracha, and I saw this shirt and I thought, why not? What's up, guys? Welcome back to Just JP. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to a viewer's request. This is the band Frost, with an asterisk at the end, with the song Dear Dead Days. This is a request by Paul Hilberger. Paul. You have been asking for this band for the longest time. I got you. Don't worry about it. I was going to do it eventually. It just takes time. So, because I have never heard of Frost, Frost is an English progressive rock supergroup formed in 2004. Give me some genres. Okay. Progressive rock, electronic rock, pop rock. It's still Friday night. I'm not going to record too much today. How's your guys' night going? What day is it for you? I have no idea what day this video is coming out. It's probably like, I don't know, maybe a Saturday or Sunday. Not quite sure yet. Not sure. Of course, you guys can join me on Twitter. You guys can join me in the comments down below. If you haven't noticed, I'm kind of always down there. I check the comments in the morning and at night. Sometimes I skip a day because I'm tired, but, you know, I gotta live. Anyways, let's get into it. Without further ado, this is Frost with the song Dear Dead Days.
Bye.
I'm sorry, I'll fix that at some point. Honestly, if I had to put that like all in like one or a few words, that was like fun prog. Does that make sense? Like, that was fun to listen to. That was cool to listen to. It just sounded cool. One of the things I really enjoyed while listening to this song were the keyboards. I really, really like the keyboard. I like the tone and the synth that they choose to play and that they chose. Maybe that's because, you know, I play video games and stuff like that, so because they sounded kind of arcadey, that's going to capture my attention and my, you know, that gets me. That gets me a little bit. But it also depends on where you put that sound, because that arcadey tone does not fit in everywhere, so you can't just bring that in out of nowhere. Here, I think that it works really well. I think it perfectly matches with the high energy pace of the rhythm that they set up, the drums just going. The riffs are really cool. The guitar riffs are just kind of fun. I don't know really how else to describe it. It just sounded like fun prog. Like, it felt like a couple of, I don't know how old they are, I'm not looking. But it felt like a couple of kids that got together with some cool stuff, and they're like, let's just play something kind of cool. Maybe I shouldn't say kids. Because what it looks like, it looks like they're adults. I don't mean any disrespect. It sounded like a couple of guys just got together, brought all their gear, and said, let's just make some cool music. And that's kind of really what I get out of it. It's cool music. As a whole, I thought it was pretty cool. Like I said, the keyboard sounds, I love that. The guitar riffs were just solid the whole way through, and they were interesting. And then the vocals, I thought, were really good along with it. I was actually expecting something a little heavier because of the sound that they kind of had at the beginning. Like, it was kind of like heavier electronics than I was expecting, and I was expecting a heavier sound to go with that. Especially when it was starting to rise and it sounded like it was going to like explode into a heavier section. But I believe it just went into the chorus, which isn't a bad thing. I was just expecting something kind of different. But I really like the way this begins. If I could just come back to this sound really quick. I think this perfectly sets up kind of what you're about to hear. Like, okay, I hear the time signature. I hear the cool sound. What's going to happen from here? from right here, not only do you get the cool riff, but you get the violin, which is actually, someone's actually playing the violin in this song, or in this band and in this album. John Mitchell, who plays the guitars and the violin, and he does some vocals also. I think that's super cool. I like the way they incorporated the violin in here, because it actually kind of sounds like just another part of that electronic keyboard, and that's electronic, let me use this word, electric symphony. It kind of just works perfectly with that. That whole part, especially the intro, and like most of the instruments throughout the song, it sounds like chiptune music, if it was done with like out the chiptune filter, basically. I don't know how many of you guys like play video games and like have listened to chiptune music and stuff like that. But go back, I don't know, I'm not going to provide a link, just go and listen to like some chiptune music. And this is what this sounds like, just without the chiptune sound. Really listening to the song, every instrument stands out in its own part, and you can tell that these guys have immense talent. And I think that's very evident from the song. It's structured superbly. It has a perfect flow, in my opinion. It moves from part to part without any sort of difficulty. It sounds easy. So this song, I liked it. I liked it. This song wasn't like a favorite. I would definitely listen to it. But this song is kind of like a gateway, because it makes me want to check out more of their stuff. I would actually be interested to see if they do anything heavier, because I felt they had all the elements, and maybe it's just curiosity. I'm just very curious. Do they have anything that's heavier? I'm sure they have stuff that's lighter, but I'm just curious. Give me the heavy stuff. So yeah, I would definitely listen to this. I didn't even do lyrics. I was totally just like forgetting about them. Home, the violence of your name still soothes me all the same. With echoes of my past, safe surroundings meant to last. So home, obviously, typically a place of safety, a place of comfort that you can always come back to. And here, the second line immediately says the violence of your name. So something happened at home. He says it still soothes him, but something happened at home. Let's see. I'm kind of getting like serial killer-ish vibes. Let's think that we're reading the lyrics. Now, I'm reading the title, Dear Dead Days. So you're basically writing or thinking about your past, right? Dead days, days that are already gone, they're dead. The past. Dead is obviously a negative connotation, so maybe dead because something bad happened. And it says, Dear Dead Days long to find us and define us, all those yesterdays that remind us we're the same in every way. Something bad happened in the past, and whatever it was, you don't want that bad, traumatic, perhaps, event to define who you are today, even though sometimes those traumas in the past can sometimes sneak their way back into our minds. But we don't want to let that define who we are in the current and in the present. I don't know. Either way, I did like the song, so thank you, Paul, so much for the recommendation, and thank you for waiting. I appreciate your patience, and of course, the patience of everyone else, because there are, guys, you guys have a lot of requests that I've worked to get through. Like, I have a list. It's right here. I don't think you can see it. Don't look at it. I'm going to spoil the future. But I have a list of requests here that I go through. I go through the comments, you know, and go through those. I mean, thank you guys so much for watching. Really appreciate it. Of course, please let me know what you guys thought of the song. Join me on Twitter. Join me in the comments down below. I say the same thing every video. Thank you guys. Have a great night. Have a great day. I'll see you tomorrow. Does that sound kind of weird? I'll see you tomorrow. Even though I will see you tomorrow. For me, it's like the same day, but for you, it's tomorrow. I don't know. That's a weird YouTube world. Thanks, guys.